the Happy Families Podcast. It's the podcast for the time poor parent who just wants answers now.
To get to a level three Christmas, yes, we get to spoil ourselves. Yes, we sing all the songs and remember the baby Jesus. But if we're going to remember his life, the best way to remember his life is to follow his example.
And now here's the stars of our show, my mum and dad.
Only 10 sleeps till Christmas Day. Mrs. Happy Families, I'm starting to feel the energy change in our family.
Are you prepped?
No.
Don't ask me if I am.
I was going to say, are you? Hello, this is Justin and Kylie Coulson. I'm the founder of happyfamilies.com.au. We are your podcast hosts for the Happy Families podcast. And today, a podcast with a difference. A few months ago, we sought your feedback on how we can make the podcast better. And one piece of feedback came through many, many times, a surprising number of times. We weren't quite sure what to do with it because we really are just here to talk parenting. But today, we're going to follow the feedback and do as so many of our listeners have asked. Many people have clued into the fact that every now and again, Kylie and I go to church. When I say every now and again, I mean every Sunday. And we take our kids along as well. And this is Christmas. And for the last week or so, we've been talking about the meaning of Christmas. We've been talking about what we're looking forward to for Christmas and how we can help our families to have a happy Christmas. Well, today we've decided that we're going to go a little bit further. We're going to talk about how to make Christmas holy for your family because this is something that we strive to do every single year with our kids.
We know not everybody has Christ at the center of their Christmas, but one of the things that I've really appreciated over the years is having the opportunity to understand and learn how other people do things.
Yeah.
It helps me to be more respectful. It helps me to have greater understanding, and it helps me to be able to connect with other people in a much more powerful way as a result of that knowledge.
Mm.
So maybe Christ isn't a part of your Christmas, but maybe some of the things that we share today will help you understand how it is for other people.
Yeah. And if you want to have a more Christ-centered Christmas, if you want to tap into the true historical meaning of Christmas, at least as it's been for a very, very long time, I know that there are going to be some people who say, oh, historically, actually, there's some intermingling of other traditions and other things in there. We're just going to focus on the Christian aspect of Christmas in this podcast because we know that there's a lot of people who have that faith background and who probably would like to help their families to have a holier Christmas. So let's dive into it. Last week on the podcast, I mentioned something called the three levels of Christmas. This is not a Justin Coulson original. I actually found it from a newspaper editor who wrote about it in 1985 in a book that I was reading. And I think that it's really, really interesting. The three levels of Christmas, level one, we'll call this the Santa Claus level. It's the level of Christmas trees and colorful gifts and candlelight and a table full of prawns and seafood. And salmon and all of the lollies.
When you were talking about overindulging at Christmas time, I just knew it was going to be prawns.
I can't help myself. I really want to eat. I shouldn't, but I really want to eat a lot of prawns this Christmas.
Well, you might have to share them this year.
Who with?
Maybe me.
You don't eat prawns.
I started cooking them.
You have started eating prawns in the last year or so. Are you saying that you like them now?
When I cook them, yes.
After a lifetime of not eating prawns, now you want to share my Christmas. You know what? It's Christmas. I'll share them with you.
I even started eating olives, and I've determined that I don't like green ones.
Right. Oh my goodness! See, I've had the lion's share of all of those good things for the last 20 plus years, and now you're saying that I'm going to have to share them.
No, you can probably have all the olives.
Alrighty, okay. Well, that's the Santa Claus level. That's level one Christmas. And you know what? I don't want to take away from it or diminish it at all. We love level one Christmas. I mean, that's what we've talked about all week on the podcast and all last week, and that's what we're going to continue talking about because most of the world really just loves Christmas because it's level one and it's a bit of overindulgence and it's a bit of relaxation. It feels good to have a level one Christmas.
Well, it also brings everybody together usually.
Yes. Yes.
The level one is all about bringing people together.
Yeah, 100%. Now, level two Christmas changes things a little bit. Level two Christmas is where we go from the overindulgence and the Santa Claus and all that kind of thing to the, let's call it the Oh Holy Night, Silent Night level. It's where we get involved in not just the Jingle Bells Christmas carols, but the really meaningful Christmas carols of the story that starts now in those days. There went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. It's the level of the crowded inn and the silent holy moment in a dark stable where Jesus came to earth.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
And I don't know about you, but when I think about that, it starts to transcend that level one. Level one is fun. Level one is delightful. And we can't get enough of level one in so many ways. But there is something deeper about a level two Christmas.
I really wish you hadn't stopped playing that.
And I played David Archuleta as well, which one of our children is going to be listening to this and just going, oh, I love David Archuleta. She's like a David Archuleta for life kind of fangirl.
Groupie.
Totally. Actually, you know what my favourite Christmas carol is now that we're talking about that level two Christmas? And I'm playing the Pentatonix version. I love this one.
These guys are amazing.
Don't know how they do this with their voice.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
And so level two Christmas is really about saying, let's acknowledge, let's recognize that there is something transcendent, something deeper about Christmas. And that's something that's really, really special. Level three is different though. Level three is about saying that we can't leave Jesus in the manger. He grows up, he becomes an adult, he takes on the sins of the world, he dies for the world. And unlike level one, where you kind of do get sick of it, you can't live that life of overindulgence for more than a day or two. Otherwise, you start to really, really get sick. And even, I can't sing Away in a Manger for more than a couple of weeks. Eventually, I kind of get tired. I'm like, let's put that away for another 11 months. I'm looking forward to next Christmas so we can do it again. But the level three Christmas is where we say, I want to focus on Jesus' gifts, the joy, the peace, the hope, what the adult Jesus brings into people's lives.
Well, and I think if you think about the way we celebrate one another's birthdays, there's obviously an acknowledgement that you were born, and in our house we share the birth story as
yes,
we do at Christmas.
Well, yes, we do.
But we celebrate the life.
Yeah.
We celebrate the life of the ones that we love. And so at Christmas time, there's this wonderful acknowledgement that for us, a belief that Jesus came to earth and he lived this life that allows me to live the life of privilege that I live and understand who I am in relation to him and how I want to live my life so that I can be more like him.
That's beautiful. Kylie, that's beautiful. I've never actually thought about that, but every year when our kids have their birthday, we tell them their birth story. We celebrate their birth, and then we celebrate their life. And so at Christmas, what a perfect thing to do. That's how we can move to a level three Christmas. We think that that's really important. And so after the break, we're going to talk about a few ideas we've got and some of our listeners' ideas as well about how to create a level three Christmas for your family while still enjoying level one and level two.
It's the Happy Families Podcast.
For a happier family, try a Happy Families membership, because a happy family doesn't just happen. Details at happyfamilies.com.au.
It's the Happy Families Podcast, the podcast for the time poor parent who just wants answers now. And today we're going a little bit rogue. We're sharing our thoughts on how to make Christmas holy.
So during the week, we've been in touch with a whole bunch of people who listen to the Happy Families podcast, and we've just asked them, how do you really celebrate the meaning of Christmas? How do you bring that into your family? And we had no idea what sort of responses we were going to get, but we were really surprised with the number of people who said, yeah, actually, it's all about the true meaning of Christmas is all about Jesus.
We are a Christian family, so for us, Christmas is mainly about the birth of Jesus and celebrating that. And on Christmas Day, we ensure that we go to church in the morning and we get to spend time reflecting on the gift of Jesus
the meaning of Christmas is about Jesus and about the birth of Jesus. We do have our carols at church, so we try and get the girls and our family involved in that.
It's actually really important to us that the commercial side of Christmas doesn't overshadow what we're truly celebrating, which is that Jesus is the saviour of the world. And it's such a beautiful, exciting day. Yes, because of the presents, but also because of what we're celebrating.
We focus on Jesus. While we do give gifts to our children, we use this as a time of giving back to others.
So let's just recap, because our listeners have kind of talked about a number of things that we were going to say, and we might just add to that just a little bit. First up, carols. I've already played a couple that are absolutely rippers because they get to the very heart of what Christmas is all about.
We might not be able to sing those carols, but one of the things that we love doing with our kids is actually going around to people who are maybe a little bit lonely. They don't have family around them at Christmas time, and just standing on their doorstep and giving a bit of a rap, 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 and then singing a few songs for them.
I thought you were going to say we were singing a rap, rap, rap. So we haven't actually done that a lot lately, but we used to do it a lot. I think we could probably reignite that again. There's something special about knocking on the door of somebody and standing there and singing. It's really personal. You're really opening yourself up, and it creates a lovely connection. The second idea that I think is worth touching on is the Nativity. Kylie, you love the Nativity.
So the Nativity would hands down be my favourite Christmas decoration. I may have a few of them.
And every time I turn around, it's like, is that the same Nativity we had last year? And you say, maybe.
Well, we have the main one.
Right.
My willow, that is.
The willow tree Nativity is beautiful.
And that's my pride and joy when it comes to Christmas. I just love their depiction. But we also have our little Fisher and Price one.
Yeah.
Which we've had pretty much since the beginning.
Yeah, yeah.
Because as soon as I realised that babies and ceramics don't go together, I knew that I could not have a Christmas without them being able to touch and feel and be a part of that process. Because it's such an important part of what we believe and how we choose to live our lives. And I wanted them to be able to hold and use their imagination. And so the Fisher-Price little Nativity is just beautiful for little fingers.
So we have some friends who have joined up with other friends. They're not local, unfortunately, so we can't do it with them. But we know of some families who get together and they actually do their own Nativity at or on Christmas or around about Christmas, where the kids are acting it out and everyone gets all dressed up and they really go to town with that. That's probably taking it to the next level. That's like level 15 Christmas. One thing that we absolutely do is we sit around the Nativity on Christmas morning, and before we dive into gifts or anything, the Santa stockings have come out, but that's about it. We open up Matthew and we open up Luke and we read, "Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost." And we read the Nativity. We read those first couple of chapters to really emphasize the importance of this for our children.
And as some of our listeners suggested, number three is attending church. Our faith, we actually don't have Christmas.
So we don't have Christmas services on Christmas Day.
On Christmas Day.
It really aggravates me. I've been complaining about this for the last, I don't know how many years, at least 10 or 15 years. And we've actually tried to just organise our own on Christmas Day a couple of times, which was met with varying degrees of discouragement from the leadership. But what a great thing to be able to go to church on Christmas Day and make that the centrepiece of your Christmas, or at least an integral part of it. The last thing that I really wanted to touch on that sort of came from the things that we've talked about over the last little while and from our listeners is just the importance to get to a level three Christmas. Yes, we get to spoil ourselves. Yes, we sing all the songs and remember the baby Jesus. But if we're going to remember his life, the best way to remember his life is to follow his example, and that's by serving others, by helping others. And over the years, we've done all sorts of things, like having people in our home, Christmas dinner, Christmas lunch. And we know many of people who actually give up their Christmas to go and knock on doors and deliver hampers and feed the homeless and do all kinds of meaningful service to those who are in need. And to be able to take your kids along and to do that kind of work, I think is just extraordinary. So powerful, so service-oriented, so giving, so big-hearted.
That's my favourite part about Christmas, the opportunity to just look outside ourselves and find those who need some Christmas cheer, who need to know that they are seen, heard and valued.
We really hope that these ideas help you to invite the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of Christmas, into your home over the next week or so. Tomorrow on the podcast, we're going back to level one, by the way. We're going to talk about budgeting and planning for Christmas and getting things right. It's actually going to be a really informative, really interesting conversation, and we can't wait to share it with you. The Happy Families podcast is produced by Justin Rulon from Bridge Media. Craig Bruce is our executive producer. And if you would like more information about making your family happier, we have got an enormous Christmas sale happening in the Happy Families store starting tomorrow and going through to Christmas Eve. Details tomorrow on the Happy Families podcast. Mm-hmm.